Hi everyone, welcome back to Gore Mountain in New York. We're at Lake Placid 2023, the FISU World University Games, and it is the semi-finals and finals of the men's and women's ski cross. The hardware is going to be handed out over the next 30 minutes or so. It's going to be a wild ride, so don't go anywhere. We've had a round robin format earlier on today. Now we've got our finalists and these two semi-finals for the women coming up first, and then it is semi-final 2-1 and 2 for the men. So a pretty dramatic set of round robins earlier on today, particularly in the women's event. We're hearing that potentially from that last round robin that we had, two skiers are not going to take their place in the finals. I'm just waiting for official confirmation, but that is a real shame for the skiers that have picked up an injury and had obviously still progressed through to the semi-finals. It'll be the women's semi-finals up first, then the men. Top two skiers in each heat go through to the finals. And if it is correct that the skiers have one skier from each semi-final has pulled out, then we won't actually have a women's small final. It will just be a final. Well, there is the view down the course. It is in absolutely perfect condition. Lin Nakanishi from Japan has skied really tidily today, picking up a couple of wins in the round robin format, a second place as well. She's now, for me, the gold medal favorite, and a big Japanese contingent have come out to support her. The finish area is absolutely packed. Well, let's get a look back at what happened earlier on today. So this was Lin Nakanishi. She's in a great position in this. Nikola Frykova from Slovakia, from Bratislava, put together enough points to go through. She'll be in the first semi-final. Jack Mitchell through for the men for the USA, man out of college in Washington. Nicholas Illig qualified through the round robin stage in second place. Series of results. He won 4 out of his 5. But Scott Johns from Great Britain, from the Manchester Metropolitan University, has been the man everyone is chasing. He won all 5 of his round robins, but it's a different game now. He'll be in the first of the men's semi-finals. It'll be the women's semi-finals up first.
And race, or whether you just want to pull up? So that's why we need to know. If you're going to run all the way to the bottom, we'd love that, because then we have TV.
So the discussion going on there, because now of the injuries, there is two skiers in semi-final 1, two skiers in semi-final 2. The bib colors wouldn't change because they go off the round robins from earlier. So effectively, we could move straight to the final for the women. What the race jury are doing is they're asking the skiers, are you going to run 2 at a time anyway? It's just so that they know.
Just all the way? Okay, cut it up.
Have fun with it, right?
Run it. Okay. Yeah. So everybody's going to go to the bottom?
Okay. We'll get a look at the course profile. We're starting at 965 meters, finish at 640 at the base station here in Gore Mountain. This 965 meter long course, it's been proving a real test. It's a fast track, but conditions are ideal. It's nice and solid underfoot. You get great purchase on the edges. It all comes down to that final jump. That is, for me, where the overtaking may take place. Here's the start section into the first of the bank turns. We'll go through it pretty quickly. Roller into the next bank and then turn 4 here. Left foot turn into another double bank. These banks come at you quickly. It's difficult to pass in these turns because there's not a lot of room between each of the banks. And at this bottom section, just have a bit more time before the final jump. And we saw a couple of skiers drafting over that final jump and trying to move out to the side and make the pass on the line. So the understanding I have is that the women are going to run the semi-finals, even though they are both skiers in each semi-final will progress. Olivia Benk had a fall in the last of the women's round robins and not able to start. So DNS for Olivia Benk from Germany. Which means these two skiers, Frykova and Kasparova, guaranteed a spot in the big final, of course. Kasparova on a podium in Krasnoyarsk 2019. Doesn't matter what order these two skiers finish in as well here. So you can cruise down in second, 30 seconds behind. But if you're in the red bib, like Frykova is, she'll still have the red bib in the big final. So it's just a real training opportunity here. It is the semi-final, but injuries, unfortunately, have caused some problems in the round-robin format. Can do that with no use of round-robin format. The injuries tend to happen to the skiers that don't progress. So at this stage of a competition, if you run round of 32, quarterfinals, semi-finals, you would have, even with a smaller field to start with, you would still have a full semi-final. But it's Frykova leading, Kasparova in second place. And they're just going to get a feel of the snow after lunch. The athletes all had a little bit of food. The venue here and the organization has been providing lots of lovely food for all of the athletes and officials. Big thank you to all of the volunteers and the team here at Gore Mountain and Lake Placid 2023 for all of the work that they've done. As Frykova and Kasparova are over the final jump, and of course they're into the big final where Frykova will wear the red bib. So just a little training opportunity there for those two skiers, and the start section, very technical. It's been causing the most problems. And Frykova seems to be handling it well. We'll see how Nakanishi gets on in the next semi-final. I think it's the right thing to do to run, even if we've just got the two skiers. Just blows away some of the cobwebs before the final. The medals are, of course, up for grabs. Cowbells are ringing out. There's the view in the start. If you're wondering what the start commands are, it is enter the start gate. Then you have the command skiers ready. From that point on, you better be ready. Following skiers ready, the starter will say attention. And any time within 5 seconds of saying attention, the board will drop.
Racers ready. Attention.
Second semi-final, Lynn Nakanishi from Japan and Elizabeth Filatrol from Canada. And Canadian skiing, that top section, start section, the best she's skied all race long. She had a bit of a problem in her first heat, went down in the start section, but she's getting dialed into this course at the right time, it's fair to say. You see the skiers just standing a little tall, just all about cruising through this course and getting through to the final unscathed. Nakanishi standing quite tall again, just giving it about 80%. Feel for the snow, feel for the skis, and then turn up the dial when it matters in the big final. Final jump for the Japanese skier. So we've got our lineup for the small. Well, we don't have a small final. We've got to line up for the big final. No small final. So Nakanishi and Frykova, the two red bibs in the semi-finals, looking like they will be the two skiers that could be vying for the gold medal. But in this game, you never know. We saw it in snowboard cross. It doesn't always go to form from the round robins or qualifying. It's a different game when you're in the straight knockouts. It's the straight knockout semi-final for the men. Semi-final one for the men coming up next. So in that big final, we'll have Frykova in red, Nakanishi in green, Kasparova in blue, and Filatrol in yellow. So we move on to the men's semi-finals. First semi-final, Scott Johns of Great Britain in the first semi-final. He wears the red bib. Lucas Richard of Switzerland in blue, Tim Olimietz of Germany in green, Charlie Lang from Canada in yellow. Scott Johns has been wearing the red bib all race long. He was pretty relaxed at lunchtime, just having a chat. He's picked the same lane every single start. So a men's semi-final one underway. It's a decent start from Johns of Great Britain, but he's got the German Tim Olimietz for company. But Johns, oh, he's in second place right now, and Lucas Richard in third. First time all race long that Scott Johns is not at the front of the race. Richard in third, Charlie Lang of Canada. And the yellow bib in fourth, but Tim Olymeets leading right now in the men's semi-finals, and Scott Johns has got the Swiss superstar behind him. Current world junior champion. Second place will do it though, but Scott Johns leaves a little bit of room. Scott Johns is in trouble, holds off the Swiss skier. And Richard is going to have to try and go round the outside, but Scott Johns holds on. Tim Olymeets takes it. Well, a big battle in that semi-final. There was a superb start from the German. Lucas Richard into the small final. For many, one of the favorites for this race. Lang in this small final as well. They'll race for positions 5 to 8. John's just not as smooth as he was in the earlier rounds. And the German's getting the wax right on that start section. Well, John's stepping on the back of Meets' ski. But Meets pulled away, powered away. And it was Richard that was causing problems for the British skier. Charlie Lang in fourth. You could see that Johns is dialed in, but nowhere really to go. And at this stage, Richard almost takes Johns out, but it's a good recovery from Scott Johns to get back on the line and hold off the Swiss skier. German skier up for it now that it really counts. So there the confirmation, Meets and Johns through. They will race for the medals as we get lined up in the start gate for the second of the men's semi-finals. Second German skier, Nicholas Illig will wear the red bib. Jack Mitchell green, Alfred Wank from Australia in blue. Robin Tissieres from Switzerland in the yellow bib.
Racers, under the gate.
Let's go, boys.
Come on, boys.
Racers, ready. Attention.
So here we go, second semi-final. Not the best of starts from the Australian in the blue bib, but it's the German, Illig, who powers through the middle, and he's going to grab the whole shot here ahead of Jack Mitchell from the USA. Wenk in third, Tissier's in fourth place. And Nicholas Illig, 21-year-old from Ansbach University of Applied Sciences, like his teammate in the previous semi-final, starting to pull away. Jack Mitchell making second place his own. Knows the snow in this part of the world. He raced here in Noram last season. Jack Mitchell now putting some distance on Alfred Wenk, who's down in third place. We're through the final turn. Nicholas Illig safely over the final jump. Jack Mitchell in second place. Team USA getting some representation in the final. Here are the men's ski cross. And Illig just had the timing the best. You see, creasing it through that top section, getting the skis on the snow, bending through, building speed. And once he got out in front, that was it. So we have our final lineup. It's Tim Olymeets, Jack Mitchell, Nicholas Illig, and Scott Johns in the men's final. As we see Illig through the final turn, and Jack Mitchell not far behind him. So the skiers will all make their way back to the top. So next race we will see will be the women's big final. The World University Games medals about to be decided. Villatrol in yellow, Nakanishi in green, Frikova in red, Kasparova in blue.
Racers, down to the gate.
Pick your favorite, hold on to your hats. Here we go.
Racers, ready. Attention.
Women's big final underway. It's a great looking start from Nakanishi from Japan. She looks like she's going to get the whole shot. She's got Prokova for company in second place, but Nakanishi leads. Prokova in second. It is Filiatrol in third for Canada. Kasparova in fourth. And that could be the real battle because Nakanishi is starting to pull away now from Prokova, but the Slovakian is not going to give up yet. Filiatrol is still holding on to third, but she nearly puts her hand down. Now she's got Kasparova for company. Kasparova, a medalist at the Krasnoyarsk Games in 2019. Has she collided with Filiatrol? Now they're all still on their feet, but that one's got this battle for bronze is going right down to the line. Nakanishi, though, over the final jump. She's going to come through and take the gold medal. Second to the skier from Slovakia, Prokova. I think Filiatrol held on for bronze, but it is gold to Japan here at Gore Mountain for Nakanishi. Superb race. She got out of the start the quickest. And from that moment on, once she was out, it didn't look like anyone was going to overtake her. Prokova put together a great day's work here at Gore Mountain. Nakanishi, the quickest with the reaction times, getting that ski to snow contact into the tuck. And Prokova following her down from this point on. But it was the battle for bronze that we were trying to keep an eye on between Kasparova. Kasparova just getting almost level with the Canadian through this final series of turns. Japanese skier has it at this stage and cruises down over the final jump to take a stunning gold medal. And what a battle for bronze. The Canadian is trying to hold off Kasparova, and she's on the tails of her skis, and she did come through and take the bronze medal. Kasparova not able to overtake Filiatrol, who picked up the bronze medal for Canada. Kasparova finishing in fourth. We'll get the official result now. Nakanishi confirmed as the gold medalist. Prokova, silver for Slovakia. And Filiatrol, a bronze for Canada. Disappointment for Clara Kasparova, but she has battled hard all day long. Has got to be proud with how she skied today. These skiers now will focus on what is about to come. Johns in red, Illigan green, Mitchell in blue, Nitz in yellow.
Race is ready. The judge.
So here we go, men's big final underway. Johns gets away better than he managed in the semi-final, but he's powering away here. Scott Johns from Great Britain leads the two Germans who are battling for that silver medal spot. It's Johns in the lead. Second right now is Meets of Germany. Illig down in third, Jack Mitchell in fourth place right now, and Scott Johns has this in the bag. Jack Mitchell in touch with the Germans, but he's in a bit of trouble. Mitchell stays on his feet, and Scott Johns is saving his best race until the final. He absolutely nailed the start, and Scott Johns through the final turn for Great Britain over the final jump, and Scott Johns takes the gold medal for Great Britain. Great Britain's first ever medal in freestyle skiing at the Winter University Games. He has dominated this race. He takes the gold medal. Meets finishes on the podium as well. But Scott Johns turns a top qualifying performance into gold. And there'll be celebrations in the British camp later on this afternoon. Medals have been hard to come by for team, for the British students over the years at the University Games.
I saw nothing.
Scott Johns delivers on the day. Plenty curling medals at the University Games, and Great Britain's curlers have been going well again here in Lake Placid. I think the last snow sport medal must have been Tarvisio 2003 for Amanda Peary in alpine skiing. My freestyle skiing, ski cross, Scott Johns does it. An absolutely dominant performance. Silver going to meet Illig getting the bronze. And Jack Mitchell from the USA, fourth place. He nearly missed the last gate, but Scott Johns doing a difficult thing in ski cross. It's one thing to win qualifying, but getting into the knockouts and the round robins. The only race Scott Johns didn't win was the semi-final, but doesn't matter, he got through. So huge congratulations to Scott Johns for Great Britain, taking the gold medal. Tim Olli meets second for Germany. Nicholas Illig in third, Jack Mitchell fourth. What a race. Philly Atterholt still smiling. She was very much an outsider for a medal, perhaps. Vincette was the favoured Canadian, but Philly Atterholt has done what she needed to do. Rykova, it picks up the silver medal. She wasn't smiling after the run, but she's smiling now, and rightly so. 22-year-old out of Comenius University in Bratislava. 13 podiums in FIS races in the Czech Republic over the last couple of years. But the gold medalist, Lin Nakanishi from Japan, just 19 years old. I think she's got a big future in this sport. How far can she go on at 19 years old? Maybe she'll be competing at this event in 2 years' time. Congratulations to all three women on the podium. Nakanishi, Frakova and Philly Atterholt.
Friends of mine are alpine racers, but kids, not adults.
Representing Germany, Nicholas
Illig. Nicholas Illig takes the bronze. He was second in qualifying, 0.34. Behind Scott Johns, he's competed at three World Junior Champs. Eighth place on the Europa Cup Tour, a great result for him, and now the bronze medal. Second goes to Tim Olli Meets, the man that's been on the podium of the Europa Cup Tour. That was in November 2021. It's actually his first start this season, and what a race, series of races he's put together. Scott Johns, the World University Games champion in ski cross. A wonderful moment for him. Switched across the ski cross as an under 16 in about 2019. He kept racing alpine skiing as well. English Super G, under 16 Super G champion in 2019. And he's been consistently quick in ski cross, winning some qualifying runs in NORAMs. But today, he has turned it into a victory in the knockout rounds. So huge congratulations to Scott Johns